listeners. Welcome to today's Buru's Diary. Just as all of us know what Buru Diary represents, it's all about what His Excellency has done, His Excellency Right Honorable Ifeanyi Ugbahi has done, what he's doing, and what he's going to do, so that we can share to the public domain for those abroad, those home, and those rural, to actually know that His Excellency is doing a marvelous work. Today, our guest today is going to be Honorable Chief Mike Owerekwe, the SPA to the Governor on Agriculture. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my highly pleasure for me to welcome Honorable Chief Mike Owerekwe.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Engineer Mike Owerekwe, Special Advisor to the Governor of Enugu State on Agriculture.
We are welcome, Honorable.
Thank you, my dear brother.
We thank you for this opportunity meeting with you, the Buru's Media and the Buru's Diary Media team. So today, we are to discuss what His Excellency Right Honorable Ifeanyi Ugbahi has been able to achieve for the past 6 years as in terms to agricultural activity in Enugu State, the rural area in focus. Because we discovered that each governor has his policy, he has his agenda. Our governor, Right Honorable Ifeanyi Ugbahi, have actually promoted the rural area. To the extent that you can discover that Enugu urban, Enugu rural area is now like urban in terms of road accessibility and thereof. So it will be of a good pleasure if you can tell us in what ways has His Excellency helped in promoting, encouraging, and empowering the rural farmers as regards to agricultural sector of the state economy.
Thank you so much, my brother. Well, you're right. When you mentioned the rural areas and how His Excellency is interested and focused on improving the lives and the economy of the rural areas. So you all know that agriculture in the rural areas of Enugu State, over 90% of the economy is dominated or contributed to by the agricultural sector. So you have, you know, farmers, cassava farmers, palm oil, you know, rice, cashew. So as a governor, you want to develop the economy of the rural area by touching and developing the sector that contributes majorly to the economy of that rural area, which is agriculture. And that is why His Excellency the Governor has keyed into various programs that helps to improve the lot of the farmers. So it started with FADAMA, which is a World Bank program in conjunction with federal government and state, and that came in and supported over 14,000 farmers across the state to produce rice better. You know, before now, people just thought that rice is when you go, you just spray your rice on the soil and then put fertilizer and wait for it to grow. So FADAMA came in and helped the farmers to improve their farming capabilities. Also give in those local governments where rice is done well, they put some what we call some rural roads that had access to the farm, so they can bring out their products from the farm, and I supported them with machines, you know, milling machines, fertilizers, rice seeds, and most importantly, training on the best practices. So we got an improvement of yield. So we also have the Agriculture Transformation Agenda program, they call ATAPS. You know, the same, it supports with a partnership with the federal government, whereby they supported farmers in cashew, nut farming, in cassava farming, across various local governments in the state. And they also went ahead to work on the bridges and irrigation facilities as Adani, so that we can have all year farming in those areas where we have irrigation systems. At the same time, the governor also now went to another program called Appeals, you know, paid counterpart funding. Appeals has trained 1,700 youths and women, and is currently empowering them as we speak. In addition to that, cooperatives across the state receiving support through the appeals program. And note, the key word here is cooperatives. So because cooperatives is like a rural company. You know, a company limited is when one person goes or two, a few people register, the company will cease. But cooperative is when like 10 people, 15 people, farmers, youth, register, put their energy together, put their resources together to for a common development. So they help each other. So government recognizes cooperatives as the minimal body through which they work with farmers for the sake of accountability and learning, you know, shared learning, shared resources. So cooperatives are being supported through the appeals program. And then recently, we have another program called the IFA, Value Chain Development Program, that came up on stream again and has finished profiling farmers. They profile farmers and they have supported farmers in their cooperatives for this farming season, especially for rice production too. And then they have gone ahead to build small milling centers, boreholes in various communities because water is very essential. And lock-up shops where you sell the products, because the whole idea is to develop the entire value chain. So the value chain is from production to processing to marketing. And so that's how His Excellency has worked with these people, these various internationally recognized organizations, to go in and deepen our agricultural practices and standards. And I'm talking about standards. His Excellency now decided, look, we need to be able to market our products, because we're talking about value chain development. So we produce rice and we want to own our own brand. So you know that this rice comes from Enugu. So people don't come from other states, buy it and go to their own state and sell it and go to their own state. So do you know that Enugu produces a lot of rice, a lot of cassava, a lot of honey, cashew? So we now trademark our products from Enugu state. So we went to the trademark commission and trademarked the Cold City rice, the Enugu garri, the Enugu honey, the suka pepe, the Enugu cashew, the Enugu okra, which is predominant in, at Aneri, and now started producing the Cold City rice. And in order to produce the Cold City rice, we said there's need for standard. So the problem is stones, you know, we need to make sure there are no stones in the rice. So His Excellency bought the stoning machines and shared to those local government areas where you have the rice production.
Where you have the rice production?
Yes, mostly in Uzuwani, Isuzo, Kano East, Ziadu local government, Anuri, and Mochi River. And then those clusters became the hub through which the Cold City rice was mopped up and bagged in our special Cold City rice bag. So if you go to marketing company now, marketing company has the sole right to market the Cold City rice. Now this is rice produced by our people. So what happens is that instead of our people struggle to go to a care market, to go to Afro market, to you know, Ore market, to go and sell, we have a mass purchase of our rice. Money enters your hand quickly, and then you can focus on the next farming. So it now has seen to the improvement of agricultural production and the economy of the rural areas.
Do they have any chance of the state government have any mechanism whereby all these products from the rural area can also be exported to any other part of the state or outside the country?
Yes, that is why we have we went to do the trademarking and then the branding. So because you don't just carry honey, for instance, and just put it in container and go and export. There are procedures, you know. You have to have NAFTAQ number, you have to have SON number, you have to now have your standard environment. So that's the process we are now. So we are now working on the ground to ensure that our products are able to be exported, that export worthy. Because I was listening to a program just now about the issues of aflatoxins and all those toxins that you find in products because they are not organic and they are not properly, the products are not properly stored. So this is the level where we are to ensure that our products are safe, and when we export, it will not be returned. And so considering the development of the agriculture sector, it relates to economic development of the rural areas. We went into discussions with various private companies, agricultural companies, and one of them responded, Tiger Foods, and came and started buying off our Nsukka Pepe. You know, Tiger Foods does spices and exports spices to the West African coast. So the pepper they're using Cameroon pepper. So they said, Nsukka Pepe has sweet aroma, it's bright red, yellow, nice. So they came and were buying, at the first instance, they bought over 10 tons of Nsukka Pepe.
Wow.
So now driving the demand, showing us that look, this is Nsukka Pepe that we are just using, enjoying and consuming, can be exported. Even if it's not exported as a standalone pepper, it can be exported in as an ingredient in this in spices, and that's what Tiger Foods has done. So, in addition to that, the His Excellency went ahead to build a ranch where we can develop a feeble breed.
It's our local breed. Okay, feeble breed.
Yeah, it's a local breed. It's a culture. It's a cultural thing, you know. So we created a mother ranch from where we will now learn how to, you know, do what we call insemination and then crossbreeding. And
where see is
how
this ranch located?
As a Nsukka local government, and just along the express as you're going to Ugula on the left. So, and it's still under development. So you see, the ranch at the end of the day will help us to get young people to learn that business. You know, so agriculture is business. So we're not talking of not just production farming, we're not talking about the processing, the proper way to process our products and marketing. So marketing has to do with branding, with packaging, and you see, so, and at the center of the whole thing is how we can encourage our youth to pay more attention to agriculture. Because my brother, if I tell you, go back to farming, what comes to mind is you should relocate to the village and go and start farming. I want to stay in Enugu and enjoy it. But now we have shown our youth that there's a spectrum, there's a value chain within agriculture. So you can go to your village, yes, but for the sake of picking up garri that has been processed by people in the village and sorting it out and ensuring that it's up to standard and packaging it and selling it to spa. You sell it to ShopRite, selling it to the video supermarket, selling to the student hostels, selling everywhere. So the youth have started. Same thing with rice, honey, same thing with honey. You know, so that is the development, and you see, it's all centered around the economy of the rural areas.
So, in your own words, so agriculture is business. That means His Excellency has done virtually good work in the agricultural sector. What other plan do you think Excellency or policy have more, because I know more is coming?
Yes, it's also good to know
that people who are listening to us can query into it, because when looking at the way things are going, a lot of people are now relocating to the rural area to participate fully in agriculture. And when you ask them why, they say, from Enugu to an area is not more than 45 minutes. Likewise in Nsukka, likewise all other rural area of the state, because of the rural accessibility of His Excellency vision towards the growth of the state. So presently now, they want to hear more. Do His Excellency have other programs as regard to the agricultural growth and development, so that most of them can create where they can grow, who they can reach, if there's any policy or any program on ground?
Well, I mentioned programs, you know, I mentioned four programs, and the truth is that our people are not keen properly to these programs, and they should do that. So key into the existing programs, go to appeals office, go to IFAD office, and key into their programs. Even the agricultural transformation agenda program, which is located at the Federal Ministry of Agriculture building, it should key in more. But above all, we all see the surge of prices of foodstuff. All who own our own little farms back here. We used to do that far back in the days. What has changed? So we should all own our little farms in the place. In as much as we came into this program of the state, we should also key in our hearts that it is high time we started feeding ourselves, so that nobody will wake up and tell us no much about the things. And by a very important program, His Excellency did was introduction of the dry season farming as a very important one. When he flagged off dry season farming last year towards November, by distributing free seeds, dry seeds, free cassava stems, improved seeds and stems, fertilizers, and agrochemicals to farmers.
To farmers.
Yes. And so, and this was distributed statewide. So we need to take advantage of this kind of event. The other day, we went and did, in conjunction with NEMA, profiling of farmers that were affected by the 2024. And as I can tell you now that free inputs, farm inputs are coming.
Okay, for those farmers who were affected by
that were profiled across several local governments of the state. So please key in, take in advantage of the rise in prices, and let's see this agriculture take as a business. Even if we produce what we eat at home, if we produce half or one third of what we eat at home, that reduces the money we give other people. You know, if our garri is made produced by us in the village, or our kindred in the village, our yam is produced by us, it will save us the stress in 2022. You save us the money that we will expect in 2022.
Okay.
And then you talk about road network. Yes, that's a very, very important thing. You know, there's this program called the Rural Access Mobility Program that is designed to connect hinterland, the villages, to urban areas where, so that products can be brought out from the farms. And you know, what His Excellency did was to further spend money on the program. The program was supposed to do normal earth road, you know, and then ensure that the road is multiple. But His Excellency went ahead to now asphalt those roads so that they can be longer lasting. And you can tell, you can attest to me that farm roads and express roads are two different kinds of roads.
Yes.
But His Excellency has gone ahead to continue to asphalt those roads. So that way we can bring our products in from the villages. But more work is continuing. More of these access roads are being done. More of programs that are going to touch the farmers are being done. And like I said, we're going to distribute products.